Hello friends. In this video, we'll talk about another popular option for a USB Zigbee coordinator from the well-known Ukrainian brand SMLite. Reviews dedicated to devices from this brand have been appearing on my channel for several years now. Moreover, my smart home system is built on SMLite coordinators. The main focus of this video is the USB version based on the CC2652P7 chip, which is called SMLite SLZB07P7. We'll look at the firmware update process using the manufacturer's web flasher, as well as the process of replacing the coordinator in a working Zigbee 2 MQTT system without repairing connected devices. You may need to replace the coordinator, for example, in cases of unstable operation or if certain devices drop off. More details on all of this coming up, but for now, as usual, I ask you to like this video, so it can reach more people who are interested in smart home topics, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device: USB Zigbee coordinator. Used SoC: Zigbee 3.0, CC2652P7. Serial: CP2102N. Serial connection speed up to 961 kbps. Antenna: external, removable, plus 3 dB. Connection: USB. Compared to the previous version SoC CC2652P, the updated P7 version has twice the internal memory and nearly twice the RAM. Protocol support remains the same: Zigbee, Thread, BLE. The transmitter power on CC2652P modules is hardware configured at the circuit level and cannot be dynamically changed via software. On the P7, it can be dynamically adjusted via software within the range from 0 to plus 20 dBm, allowing you to adapt transmitter power depending on the conditions. Overall, the CC2652P7 is more powerful and offers flexible configuration options. The device comes in a small black cardboard box with attractive printing. By the way, the network version of the coordinator based on the same chip, called SMLite SLZB06P7, link to the review is in the video description, is packaged in a similarly styled box. The color scheme changes depending on the type of module used. On the back of the box, brief technical specifications, a list of what's included in the package, and the address of the official webpage. You'll find this, along with other necessary links, in the video description. This is what the coordinator looks like in its transport position. The antenna is removable and disconnected for easier packaging. Everything is secured and doesn't rattle around inside the box. The device casing is made of semi-transparent plastic and everything is neatly assembled. The coordinator is very compact. In this slide, for scale, it's shown next to a regular matchbox. As I mentioned, the antenna is removable and connects via a standard RPSMA connector. It operates in the 2.4 GHz band, is omnidirectional, with a gain of plus 3 dB. Here's a comparison with the Sunoff Zigbee Dongle P, which I recently mentioned and showed in a Zigbee 2 MQTT beginner's tutorial. In fact, I plan to swap them. I'll disconnect the Sunoff and install the SMLite in its place so that all devices in Zigbee 2 MQTT remain connected. Here's the hardware part for those interested. In addition to the CC2652P7 SoC, you can also see a 48 MHz crystal oscillator required for the microcontroller's operation and the power circuit, a DC-DC converter for 3.3 volts. The assembly is neat and of high quality. Before starting to use it, it makes sense to update the Zigbee firmware. We'll take the simplest route, using the manufacturer's web flasher. The link can be found in the description. Connect the coordinator to a free USB port. In the list on the left, select the appropriate model name. Click the firmware update button. In the window that appears, select the port that the system has assigned to the coordinator. Click the connect button. Here you can choose which firmware to install, for a Zigbee coordinator or for router mode. The device can also work as a Thread border router, and you can specify your own firmware file. I selected the first option. Wait a bit for the firmware process to complete. Everything is as simple as possible, No need to open the case or hold down any buttons. Just plug it into a USB port, and that's it. Done, the firmware is updated, and now we can move on to the next steps. Disconnect the SM light from the working computer. I demonstrated the installation and setup of Zigbee 2 MQTT with the Sunoff ZB Dongle P USB Zigbee Coordinator in my tutorial designed for beginners. This is the exact same system. The firmware version here is 2024-0710. Take note of the coordinator address. It ends with the digits 27728. Let's keep that in mind. In addition to the devices shown in the mentioned tutorial, I specifically added a few more for this review. Everything is working fine, with signal quality levels ranging from 91 to 153. But I'll say right away, that's not the most indicative parameter. Here's what the network map looks like. The coordinator, two routers, and six end devices. Three of them are connected directly to the coordinator, and the other three are connected through the routers. Go to Settings, then select Add-ons, and then Zigbee 2 MQTT. You need to stop it. Click the Stop button and switch to the Log tab. Wait until a message appears confirming that Zigbee 2 MQTT has stopped. The Info tab should look like this. Refresh the page in your browser if necessary by pressing F5. Now disconnect the old coordinator from the smart home server and plug in the new one. Let's check the port address, go to Settings, then to the System tab, and there select Hardware. Then click on All Hardware and look for the port address. In this case, it hasn't changed. It's still TTY USB 0, so there's no need to change anything in the configuration file. If the port is different, you'll need to replace the old one with the new one. Now you can go back to the Add-ons tab and start it. You can monitor the process in the Log tab. The first launch of Zigbee 2 MQTT will take longer than usual, as the system will restore network data from a backup file. After a while, the log will update and a message will appear indicating a successful start. Let's look at the system page. The firmware version installed is slightly earlier, dated March 16, 2024. Remember the coordinator address I pointed out earlier? It hasn't changed. That's how it should be, so that the connected devices continue to work. This is what the list looks like immediately after the first launch. Two devices have already updated their data. Some still show the last response time from the previous coordinator. And this is a minute later. I checked all the devices by pressing buttons and bringing a magnet near read switches. Everything responded and was controllable. Everything is working properly with the new coordinator. There was no need to repair anything. Here's the current network map. One of the end devices decided to reconnect to a router instead of the coordinator. It likely happened when the coordinator was disconnected. By the way, if you need to rebuild routes in the Zigbee network, you can physically disconnect the coordinator for a few hours. Then end devices will mostly switch to the routers. If the network is functioning normally, you won't need to reconfigure anything. A few hours later, everything is working fine. The signal level is about the same, though the lower limit is slightly higher. There's not a single device with LQI below 100. The signal strength of these coordinators is identical. But again, I want to emphasize, this is not a very reliable metric. Sometimes a device with a signal level above 200 works unreliably, while one with a level of 10 operates without a single dropout. As I mentioned, the need to replace the coordinator may arise in cases of unstable performance or when certain devices disconnect. Considering its low cost and the simplicity of replacement, this is a perfectly viable method. If the network is relatively small, up to 100 devices, one coordinator should handle it. If there are more, consider running a second Zigbee 2 MQTT instance with a new coordinator. If you'd like an updated tutorial video on this topic, let me know in the comments. That's all for now. I hope the video was useful and interesting to you. I'd appreciate your likes. They help with visibility on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I'll leave links to all the resources mentioned, as well as to my Telegram channels, social media, and discussion groups on smart home topics. Join us, it'll be interesting. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Peace to all.